Use less than, greater than, or equal to compare the two fractions 21/28 and 6/9. Now, your impulse might just be look at these numbers and say, oh, look, these are larger numbers than those. This must be bigger. You cannot do that. And we'll talk about in future videos on why that is, or I encourage you to think about why you cannot do that. But to do it properly, at least in my mind, the best way is to get these both in simplified forms and to just think about what they represent. And in the future, when we learn to convert them to decimals, that's actually the best way to do it, or actually for me the easiest way. But let's try to do what we can so far. So 21 over 28, if we want to put this in simplified form, 21 is the same thing as 3 times 7. 28 is the same thing as 4 times 7. They're both divisible by 7. Now, if you divide the numerator and the denominator by 7, if you divide both of the 3 times 7 divided by 7 is just going to be 3. 4 times 7 divided by 7 is just going to be 4. So this guy right here is 3/4, is equivalent to 3/4. Now let's think about what 6/9 is. Let's think about what 6/9 is. 6 over 9. And since these numbers are smaller, this is actually a good chance to visualize it. So let's visualize what, if we have 9ths, so we have, let me draw the 9/9 first. So if I were to split it into, let's see, if I were to split it into thirds, I just want to make it so it's reasonably, no, that's not right. Maybe there and there. And then divide each of these into thirds. So just like that. No, a little bit more space to that one. And then we have it like that. And then this one into thirds. Let me draw it like that. So here we have 9 pieces of a candy bar, whatever you want to think about it, or 9/9. 6/9 literally means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6/9 represents 6 of the 9 potential pieces, or 6 of these 1/9 of a candy bar pieces, however you want to think about it. Now, 6 is the same thing as 2 times 3. So you could view it as 2 groups of 3. So you could view it as, let me do it this way. You could view it as 2 groups of 3. So this is 1 group of 3. This is 1 group of 3 right there. And that is another group of 3. These are 2 groups of 3. Now, what is 9 equivalent to? 9 is equivalent to 3. 3 times 3, or 3 groups of 3. So 9 is equivalent to, that's 1 group of 3. That is 2 groups of 3. And now this is 3 groups of 3. 3 groups of 3. So we could redraw this as, so if we just draw just the groups of 3, it would look like this. If we just drew the groups of 3, it would look like this. It would look like this. And these 6, or these 2 groups of 3 that the 6 represents, if we just draw the groups of 3, would be that guy and that guy right over there. So how many groups of 3 do we have? How many thirds do we have if you consider each of those groups of 3 as a third? Well, we have 2/3. This is equivalent to 2/3. But doing the process that we're used to doing, we could imagine 6 is 2 times 3. 9 is 3 times 3. If you divide 2 times 3 by 3, you get 2. If you divide 3 times 3 by 3, you get 3. So 6/9 is the same thing as 2 over 3. 2 of the thirds, of the 1/3. That's what 6/9 is equivalent to. Now, let's think about what's larger. 2/3, which is the same thing as 6/9, or 3/4. I didn't do 21/28 because it would have taken forever to draw. So what does 3/4 look like? What is 3/4? So if we were to take this exact same square, so let me redraw it. So if we were to take that same exact candy bar, so these should be the same size. Instead of cutting up into 3 pieces, if we were to cut it up into 4 pieces, what do we get? So let's see, that's cutting up into 2 pieces, and now let me cut it up into 4 pieces. So now this one has 4ths, this one has 3rds. 3 in the denominator here, so let me make it very clear. This represents 2/3. Now this is going to represent, we have four pieces, and if we're coloring in three of them, so if we're talking about 3/4, that's 1. Let me draw it like this, actually. That is 1, 2, let me scroll up a little bit, 3. This is 3/4. And the way I drew it, it is not completely obvious to you. Actually, let me draw it a little bit neater than this. Let me draw it a little bit neater, and it'll become a little bit more obvious. I didn't draw the fourths. Here, drawing neatly actually matters. So let me draw it like that, and then split this group. Nope, I want to make it even. So I want to make it like this. OK, so if those are the fourths, if we're talking about 3/4, we're talking about, so if we're talking about 3/4, we're talking about 1, 2, 3/4. And you can see that 3/4 is larger than 2/3. 2/3 gets us to this far of the candy bar, while 3/4 is a little bit more of the candy bar. 2/3 is about that far. 3/4 is even more. So 3/4 is larger than 2/3. And we'll show you in the future how to do it numerically. We could use a calculator if you like, or you could do it by hand. But you can see from this visually that 3/4 is greater than 2/3. Now they want us to compare these two fractions. So 21/28 is the same thing as 3/4. So 21/28 is going to be greater than 2/3, which is the same thing as 6/9. And so we are done.